Fine. So the partial pressure of ethane over a solution containing 6.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams of ethane is 1 bar. If the solution contains so many, 5 to 10 to the power minus 2 grams of ethane, we have to find out what should be the partial pressure of the gas. Now see, this must be mixed with something. Fine. Something. So let that be sort of x moles. So let the other component have n moles in the solution. Okay, in the solution it has n moles in the solution. Fine. Now what happens? So I also don't know the vapor pressure due to the pure ethane, right? I don't know that. Now you should mark one thing. Ethane is a gas. Fine. Ethane itself is a gas. It is not a liquid. So what are we trying to do? Instead of Raoult's, you will be using the Henry's law. It is gas over a solution. Okay. And how do we go about it? The pressure of the gas is equal to KH into X, where X is the mole fraction of this in the solution, correct? So how do we go about it? So pressure is 1 bar. So this is 1 is equal to KH into into so 6.5 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams. C2H6 has how many? This is 24 and 6, 30. So 30 grams. That is the molecular mass of this. Okay. Now what? So 6.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams of ethane contains how much mole? This divided by 6.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 30. So that is 2.1 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4 moles. Is it not? I divided this by 3 and that 10 I took there. Fine? Round it off. 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4. Fine. So many moles of it. Now the mole of the of that solvent, that remains constant, right? So what I say is this is equal to mole fraction. What is the mole fraction? It is 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4 upon 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4 plus n, correct? By Henry's law, this happens. Now what next?
That is very small figure, so we can just...
You don't know whether this is also very small. that we do not know yet. We don't know if that yet.
Then we'll have two equations and three unknown variables. So we won't be able to solve it.
KH is a constant, obviously.
Yeah, but both. We have two equations and three variables because the pressure is not known in the third equation, right?
If the solution contains 5 into 10 to the power is 2 grams of ethane, let us see. So, what is the mole now? So 5 into 10 to the power minus 2 grams of ethane contains 5 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 30. So that gives me 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 3 moles of that. Correct? So, I don't know the partial pressure. If we neglect this in comparison to this, then it is quite solvable. But if we don't, we won't be able to solve that. So you'll have to neglect it. Okay? So the first equation gives you KH into 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4 upon N. See, even otherwise, the solubility of the gas in the one bar is C, an atmospheric pressure, rather slightly less than that. At this atmospheric pressure, the mole fraction of the gas that is dissolved has to be very less in comparison to the mole fraction of the solvent. For example, for oxygen it is 5 ppm, for HCl it is slightly more, but it is not so huge that it will start becoming comparable to this. Okay, so you can give that logic and neglect it, because then only you will be able to solve it, else there is simply no other way out. 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by N. So what do we do? If I divide this equation by this equation by this. Dividing 2 by 1, dividing 2 by 1, we get, what do we get? We get P upon 1 is equal to KH into 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 3 upon N into N upon 2.19 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, so P gives you, and there is a KH also here. This KH is there. So this KH cancels,
and
N also cancels, and you're left with 10 into 1.67 divided by 2.19. What is that?
7.6.
No, it cannot be greater than 1. But has to be less than that.
0.76.
Oh. 2. I was giving the final answer. 1.67 divided by 2.19. That gives you 0.76255. Hold on. 0.762
So that is 7.62 bar.
If it was say 5 into 10 to the minus 3, then obviously it will become 0.76. किसका? प्रेशर ज़्यादा होता जाएगा तो उसकी इसका मोल फ्रैक्शन बढ़ने लगेगा. इफ़ यू स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग द प्रेशर,
इसका ज़्यादा प्रेशर ना, ये ज़्यादा वॉलेटाइल है ना, तो मतलब
दूसरा वाला तो इज एब्सोल्युटली नॉट वॉलेटाइल. Ethane hai, it is in the gaseous form. It is like, you know, they are kind of trying to make an ethane water, like soda water. You know. So what is happening there, what you do, though obviously some of the pressure will be contributed by water. In a Coke bottle, you primarily do what? You primarily take only one of the components as volatile. You take, to that we'll just now go to that only. So what happens in liquid solution, you consider both of them evaporating. Here you consider one of them is not evaporating, Henry's law, and so that's why you'll find that Henry's law is a special case of Raoult's law. There the evaporation of the second component you do not consider, okay, you consider only one of the components which was kind of so volatile that all of it has become gas except for a very minor that remains. So that's why everything is being contributed by one of them. And in comparison to that, because in Henry's law you are taking only due to the gas, right? This is the mole fraction in solution state of which the gas. Do you get that? In Henry's law, you do not have two components. Ideally, it should have two components.
Sir, but one thing, the solution contains 6.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams of ethane, right? So 6.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 the moles of ethane plus N. And in the second solution, they are given 5.10 to the power minus 2 grams of ethane. So won't the solution proportion change?
Like it will, but
N,
it
won't
but
N
in,
be different?
Yes, it will. No, N won't be different.
Why?
N is the absolute number of moles, no? It's not mole fraction. N is the absolute number of moles. It is the same water that you are considering. So it is the same Coke bottle that you are considering. It's only that by increasing the pressure, you have been able to infuse more of the carbon dioxide, if you are able to understand in terms of that. So if you increase the pressure over the solution, then you will be able to pump in more of the carbon dioxide into the water. In this case, ethane. So
moles of ethane increases.
And that I had told you that earlier we were saying that more the pressure, more is the mole fraction in the solution.
So
they inverted it. They said more the mole fraction here, more is the pressure above.
So by that we can find the pressure required to give this much amount of.
They do that. And they keep it cool also, when chilled.